Okay, so now we are on the last part of our adjusting entries, which is the doubtful accounts or the bad debts. Doubtful accounts or bad debts is under non-cash adjustments. Ano nga uli ang doubtful accounts? These are portion of the accounts receivables which are considered uncollected. Ito yung parte ng ating ng mga pautang ng company na kinukonsider na nila na hindi na nila makokolekta. It could be because na nasunugan yung kanilang pinautang, or pwede rin namang na-bankrupt, or pwede rin namang talagang hindi na lang sila binayaran, tinakbuhan na sila. So, under doubtful accounts, meron din tayong two methods. The allowance method, which is accepted by the GAAP, which is the Generally Accepted Accounting Principle. Under allowance method, debit is doubtful account expense and credit is allowance for doubtful accounts. Recognize bad debt loss when the account is doubtful of collection. So, pag doubtful yung company na hindi na nila makokolekta yon, nire-recognize na agad na bad debt loss siya. Meron pang other one, which is the other method na direct write-off method. This is naman yung tinatanggap ng BIR. Ang debit nito is bad debt expense and credit accounts receivable. Recognize bad debt loss only when accounts are proven to be worthless or uncollectible. So dito, ang bad debts can only be recognized kapag na-prove ni company na hindi mo na talaga siya makokolekta. Okay, let's have an example. Number one, ABC Company has a balance of 80,000 accounts receivable. How much is the bad debt expense of accounts receivable if it is expected that 6% is uncollectible at the end of the year, December 31, 2021? Sabi daw, si ABC Company may accounts receivable siya na 80,000. 6% doon kinukonsider ng company na bad debt or uncollectible na siya. So, to compute, 80,000 na accounts receivable multiply by 0.06 or the 6% is 4,800. If ire-record mo yan, ire-record mo ang adjusting entry mo under allowance method, doubtful accounts expense is debited for 4,000 pesos at credit allowance for doubtful account of 4,800. If under naman siya ng direct method, direct write-off method, debit mo is bad debt expense, same pa rin, 4,800. And then credit, accounts receivable, 4,800. Okay, this is the second example. Madali-dali. ABC Company has an accounts receivable of 20,000. It is estimated that 1,200 will not be collected. Adjusting entry will be, sabi daw, si ABC Company meron siyang accounts receivable na 20,000. Inestimate nila na out of the 20,000, yung 1,200 hindi na nila makokolekta. So wala na tayong computation, binigay na nila agad yung amount na hindi makokolekta. So let's just have the adjusting entry. If it is allowance method, debit doubtful account expense of 1,200 and then credit allowance for doubtful account 1,200. If direct write-off method naman yan, Your debit is bad debt expense, same amount, 1,200. And then credit allow accounts receivable of 1,200. Oh, last example. Lagyan natin ng ano, sales return. ABC company are on credit basis. The following information are available. Ang sales is 850,000. Sales return is 40,000. Company provides for doubtful accounts expense at the rate of 3% of the net sales. Okay, so for us to compute that, si doubtful account expense si net is equal to si net sales daw, i-minus mo muna si sales return, then multiply by the rate. So, 850,000. Yan, si 850,000. I-minus mo si sales return. Ano nga ba ang sales return? Ito yung binalik ng customer. So, 850,000 minus 40,000. Saka mo i-multiply by 0.03, which is the 3%. Now, you have the amount of 24,300. To compute, adjusting entry is doubtful account expense debit 24,000 and credit allowance for doubtful account 24,300. Bakit mali? Ito ay 300. Oh, huli na lang nagkamali pa. Ayan. Ulitin natin, debit doubtful accounts expense of 24,300 and then credit allowance for doubtful account 24,300. Ayun. So that would be the last topic for the adjusting entry, the doubtful accounts.